And now for a really risible question. Who was doing the best stand-up 500 years ago?
Was it you?
Well, Ken Dodd must be on your klaxon, surely.
I sat next to Ken Dodd at the most glorious dinner one time. We were together for about 4 hours. He didn't stop. He'd just done a show and he just carried on.
Yeah.
It was astonishing.
We saw him like 2 months before he died or something. And it was about 3 hours after the time it was meant to. It was about one in the morning. Mm.
People frequently coach loads of pensioners with a driver saying, I've got to drive you back to the hotel. But we haven't seen the Diddy Men.
It was one of the best evenings of my life.
Was it endearing or was it quite irritating?
Well, I had Julian Fellowes on the other side, so it was terribly endearing.
What is this dinner?
Honestly.
It's a dream.
The best stand-up 500 years ago.
1500.
So we are talking 16th
Luther.
Century.
Martin Luther.
Well, German priests.
German priests?
So, we're in the right...
Like Henry VIII's time, is it?
Yeah, Henry VIII's
time, yes. Germany went a bit crazy in the early 16th. Well, I mean, not the craziest it's ever gone.
No. But,
I mean, they've got form.
Yeah, but relatively, because there were huge, horrible wars and fighting between the various Protestant and Catholic bits, weren't there?
There were. But this is a proper thing called Rhesus Paschalis, so the Easter laugh. And the idea was to put jokes into the Easter sermons. It supposedly reflected a perception that the resurrection was a practical joke played on the devil.
He's not going down well.
So, look at him. He's fantastic, isn't he?
We've all had an audience like that. He's going, stop!
So, the sort of shtick that they would do from the pulpit, there was a preacher who ate pancakes while doing cuckoo impressions.
Oh, brilliant.
There was one who lay in cow dung and pretended to give birth to a calf while hissing like a goose.
Oh, that's a bit try-hard, isn't
it? I know, really. Yeah. And one church where the priest got a layman to dress in a hood and convinced him he was a priest, which I think that's not as good. Yeah. But there were loads of lewd jokes about nuns, there was general bad language, and lots of serious-minded churchmen at the time, people like Erasmus, they thought it was a dreadful thing. Erasmus denounced the sermons so full of obscenities that a decent man could not tell them at a dinner party without shame. So this practice of Rhesus Paschalis was banned.
Where did Jesus stand on obscenities? Is there a view expressed in the Gospels about obscenities?
Well, he must be a bit annoyed his name is used as an obscenity.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, that way, if everyone was like, Alan Davis off.
Yeah.
Alan Davis.
But no one says Jesus,
Jesus
off.
Jesus off.
It counts as taking the Lord's name in vain.
Yeah.
Jesus.
People go, oh, Jesus Christ. Off. If someone went, oh, Davis. I wouldn't go, well, I'd never
Jesus
be so
Jesus off. We need to start that being a thing.
Yeah.
Just Jesus. Oh, just,
Jesus
is that
off.
Where you tell someone to go away but come back 3 days later?
Yeah. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.